Before we break down the latatest Minnesota Vikings roster moves on the 80-man roster cutdown day, if you think that Justin Jefferson is the number one and the best receiver in the NFL, because you know we have eyes, hit that big red button and subscribe right now. We've got several roster moves to get into for the Minnesota Vikings. Before we do that, today's show is sponsored by Mint Mobile. Plans start as low as $15 a month. They run on the largest 5G network. So if you're trying to save some money, thanks inflation, you should make the switch over to Mint Mobile. It's mintmobile.com/chatsports. More on them later on in today's show, but you're here for the breaking news. All the different roster moves made mostly today, but a couple were also made yesterday by the Minnesota Vikings. Let's break them all down. First up, the release of wide receiver Albert Wilson. Maybe not the biggest surprise. You can wind back the tape to when we first broke down this particular signing by Minnesota that I didn't really think he was going to end up making the 53, and that does remain the case as the veteran, did a little bit in the preseason, made some splash plays, but wasn't involved at all in week two of the preseason performance, and I thought was a pretty clear sign from the beginning. When players got healthy, the Vikings weren't going to need Albert Wilson as long as some of their young guys, you know, Amir Smith-Marset, Jalen Naylor, as long as those guys flashed and improved, and if B.C. Johnson, I assume, will make this team. The numbers game didn't favor Albert Wilson. Amir Smith-Marset is going to be one of your return men. When that was made clear, there simply was no need for Albert Wilson, because when in doubt, NFL teams, to a T, will always go with the young player, the cheaper player with unknown upside than the proven vet who is probably on the decline at this point in his NFL career. So our first question of the day, how many wide receivers do you think end up making the Vikings roster? Could be five, that's on the low end. Six or seven might be a bit more in line from that one. Sound off for me in the comment section. All right, next up, the waving slash injured designation for defensive tackle Julian Taylor, 24 hours from his release. If he clears waivers, he will then revert to IR. I would expect Taylor to end up clearing waivers. That wouldn't be a huge surprise to me. Frequently, the players who are waived injured have a minor injury. They might get an injury settlement off of IR if the team doesn't want to pay him all year. But Taylor gets released by Minnesota just to, you know, help free up the roster spots. Got to get down from 85 or 86 in some cases down to 80 before the roster cutdown day, 4 p.m. Eastern today. That is what ended up happening today for the Minnesota Vikings. So how many years have you been a Vikings fan? Producer Patrick's been one for life, right? Entire time? Or did you pick 22 years for producer Patrick. Yeah, that's how young he is right there. Sound off for me in the comment section. How many years have you been a Vikings fan? This will be the pinned comments on today's show. So if an ad break happens to come here on YouTube, take advantage of it. Head down there and let me know how long you've been a Vikings fan. Next up, a just straight up cut tight end, Sean Beyer. You know, not a huge surprise. It just makes sense, right? You've got Irv Smith, got Johnny Munt. We're hoping Irv Smith's healthy this year. Beyer, I don't think anybody thought was going to make the 53. I look at a lot of different roster projections out there for all the NFL teams, and I don't think I saw Beyer on a single one of them from that standpoint. You have Zach Davidson. You have Nick Muse. You still got Ben Elfson. The need for Beyer was basically non-existent from that perspective. Hopeful on Davidson. There have been some ups and some downs so far, but Beyer was a logical cut. Maybe one of the bigger names cut today by the Minnesota Vikings was cornerback Harrison Hand. I'm sure many of you remember him. It's not been the best when he's played. We'll break down Hand, what his release means for the rest of the teams, namely the corners. But first, let's tell you more about today's presenting sponsor. That's Mint Mobile. Start saving today with unlimited talk and text, high-speed data on the largest 5G network, by the way, the chance to make a mobile hotspot, unlimited premium wireless that starts at just $15 a month over at mintmobile.com/chatsports. I'll put that link in the comment section and, of course, in the description for you guys as well. Cell phone wireless provider owned by Ryan Reynolds. Don't just take my word for it or the star of the terrible X-Men Origins movie with Deadpool. You can trust my mother and my sisters as well. Unlimited premium wireless at mintmobile.com/chatsports. Save money without sacrificing your coverage or your speed with Mint Mobile. Back now to Harrison Hand. 5 tackles last year. I thought he was going to fight for maybe one of those last roster spots with everyone's favorite Vikings corner, Chris Boyd. I mean, I guess they're better than Bashaud. Really, that's a different conversation, I guess, in the end. Minnesota's begun to overhaul this cornerback room. You signed Chandon Sullivan. I wouldn't totally rule out Perry Nickerson, a guy I liked a lot coming out of Tulane, which I think we can just say I was wrong about at this point. Andrew Booth and Caleb Evans will make this team. Boyd's still kind of, you know, probably on the outside looking in. The release of Hand does give him a chance to catch on somewhere else as maybe a practice squad or backup somewhere. Let's go to linebacker, staying on defense now. Ryan Connolly placed on the reserve pup list. Today's the first day that you could put someone on the pup list. It does allow him to come back at some point this year, potentially. Would require him to miss at least 4 weeks, so we'll wait and see on that standpoint for Ryan Connolly. My suspicion here is you probably won't see Connolly make the 53-man roster. He was banged up some last year, didn't make a big impact. The Vikings had other options at linebacker. You draft Brian Asamoah the third round this year. You have Troy Dye, Chaz Surratt, Blake Lynch. I think you can just kind of stash Connolly when it's all said and done. So the Vikings will mostly use two linebacker sets. So we'll label Asamoah on there as linebacker three since he's the new guy, but it's going to be mainly two linebacker usage for Minnesota this season. That's how the vast majority of teams run. They're really more of a true 3-4 unit. So it's if we don't include the edge rushers, Danielle Hunter, you know, Za'Darius Smith as linebackers, which we shouldn't be doing. It's 2022, after all. Two off-ball linebackers is what you'll see the most for this Minnesota Vikings team. The final cut then, wide receiver Blake Prohl. We didn't show him on the wide receiver depth chart. Now you know why. He's been removed to the reserve pup list as well. More on him and the wide receiver room as a whole. But first, which roster cut surprised you guys the most? Sound off for me in the comment section. I guess I'll go Harrison Hand, just from a relatively known name recognition, but sound off for me in the comments. The final move, of course, was Blake Prohl being released, and the last name's fun. He never had any real chance, I thought, of making the 53. Maybe the music career can get really going now for Prohl. As long as he's on the reserve pup list, he'll be able to rehab with the team, etc., get paid, stash him for next year. I call these types of moves sometimes injury stashes, where you don't have the numbers. You can't carry Jefferson and Thielen and Osborne and Amir Smith-Marset and B.C. Johnson and maybe Jalen Naylor, maybe Jackson, who I know some people like as well, Tristan Jackson, and expect, oh, it's not going to work out. It's too many names, too many numbers on that 53-man roster to make room for all those receivers. So because of it, it starts to make a little bit more sense in terms of just keeping space available and injury stashing someone, and maybe next year things change. If you haven't already, make sure you guys are subscribed to us here at Minnesota Vikings Now. When news happens, we break it down. We'll be back again after week three of the preseason and the regular season and, you know, pretty much every single day this year with all the latest on the Minnesota Vikings.